Yeah, this was definitely worth the 25 hours of pain. Hello everyone and welcome. Today I answer the question, can I beat Dark Souls 2 while only leveling adaptability? So, yes, for the inevitable, isn't this just SL1 with extra steps? Comments? You are absolutely correct, but don't let that stop you from commenting it though. I just had so much fun doing resistance only, I figured I would move on and do ADP only too. So, I make my character and name him Bear Grylls, but I make sure to make him legally distinct due to international copyright laws. The game asks me if this is my true self, and yep, I am definitely this yoked in real life, 100%. Ah, Majula, such a peaceful place. Too bad it's attached to the objectively worst Dark Souls game, and I'm saying that as someone who likes Dark Souls 2. I grabbed the Morning Star because even though I can't use it, it does about as much damage as the dagger you can get. Wow, never mind, this thing sucks! I bet my fists would do better. I was making a joke, but my fists are actually better. Whatever, I'm gonna change weapons anyway. All I have to do is get to Malentia. Joke's on you guys, the bonfire's right there. Malentia here has a couple items I want, but I forgot one very important thing. Money. I'm broke. Fortunately, I know just the guy to see about that. On my way, I tried to get the Ring of Binding a little early. Yeah, maybe naked and with only fists wasn't the play. Dragon Rider. I don't even have a joke for him. Right, so that's 12k souls banked. I did take the bonfire aesthetic so I could make this area a new game plus and get even more souls if I wanted to, but it isn't really necessary. I buy the key to let Not Andre into a shop and buy the mace and level it up to +3. Now I could take out Moglin for his clothes and get even more souls, but I think I'll let him live. For now. Back in the Forest of Fallen Giants, I attempt to take out the pursuer early. It didn't go as planned. God, I hate this stupid mace. I can't wait to replace it with a vastly superior weapon of literally anything with more range than a limp noodle. Faster, 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 faster. Not even close. Okay, I think it's finally time to start putting levels into my chosen stat. So what exactly is ADP? Basically, it's a stat that governs several attributes. Poison bonus, poison resist, bleed resistance, petrify resistance, curse resistance, and most importantly, agility. Now, agility does two things. One, it increases the amount of time it takes to use a consumable, and two, it increases the amount of iframes on a roll. That's right, they tie the ability to properly dodge attacks to a stat. On paper, this doesn't sound like a terrible thing, kinda reminds me of the old school RPGs, but in practice, it kinda sucks. Well, to be fair, for PvE, it doesn't really matter. You get so many souls in this game that you're bound to have enough to level ADP to whatever you see fit. For PvP, I'm sure it was annoying to factor into builds, but as you can see by the fact that I am offline right now, that's not my problem. Anyway, the goal of the run is to max out ADP while leaving everything else at base stats, which means I'm going to need a lot of souls. So on to the first boss, the Last Giant. Would you believe me if I told you he was difficult? Well, you shouldn't, because that was a lie. The Last Giant goes down hitless on the first try. You know, I said that like it's some kind of crowning achievement, but I'm pretty sure with a tiny bit of practice, a 2-year-old could hitless him. On to the true boss of the area, Dude with Sword number 1 of 462. Alright, let's talk pursuer strats. It's walk to the right. That's it. Dodge the occasional sweep. I'm actually dodging way more than necessary in this counter. I've seen people literally just walk circles around him, but I'll be damned if I let him beat me twice in one run, so I just played it safe. Soon enough, the One Ring is mine. Over in the Lost Bastille, I light a fire under McDuff's ass without using any fire, then have him upgrade my mace to a +5. If I have to use it, I might as well make it hit hard. Next, I awaken Rosabeth, who is much nicer than me. Like, imagine if you were turned to stone, and the first thing you saw when waking up is this face? Yeah, no thanks. In the Shaded Woods, I grab the red Tearstone ring. I don't really know if I'll use it, but it's always good to have some extra tools. I also grab the Chloranthi ring +1, which in comparison to RTSR, might as well be super glued to my finger. With that, I think it's time to take on Nashka. Emo Quaylag is as easy as ever. I just slam the hard end down on her face until she goes down. Also, I hit her with my mace until I win. Changing directions, I want to head to Huntsman's Copse. I should probably just commit Unalive on Lycia here, but it's fine. Merciless Rowena, huh? I've seen enough Supernatural to know where this is going. Just call me Sam. Righto, the Skeleton Lords. As you would expect, they are easy. No, that is definitely not a setup for some insane death montage. What? I said it wasn't. Do you really think I would try and set up a bait and switch like that? Don't answer that. Anyway, the Bone Bros get dusted. Nothing happened in Earthen Peak, so I'm just gonna skip to Jabba the Hutt. No, you know what? No. We all shit on Covetous Demon because bad, but I'm gonna try and say something nice about him. Oh, I know! His nails! They look like they were professionally done. He must have a good manicurist. That's it, that's all I got. Forlorn shows up to be a fourth thorn in my side. Too bad for him, I practice the art of beating him in the face with a mace, then I get the work hook. After that, I punch Kale square in the cabbages and he politely hands over his helmet. And now, with hook and stupid hat, I can wield the rapier. I don't usually like thrusting weapons, but the superior range really helps out when needing to take down enemies. I make it a +6, then head to Brightstone Cove, Seldora. Thankfully, because I am leveling ADP, I don't need to spend any time farming the peasants. I dive into the Prowling Magus fight and it's definitely an encounter. I mean, there is music and stuff. I actually struggled to hit one of the hollows on the ground, but eventually he leaned into my attack and it worked out. So I was planning on doing Freya, but I kind of forgot you can't one-hand the rapier with a torch without more stats. Oops. So instead, I went over to Mytha and I Wait, how long has she had horns? No, really, I'm just now realizing this. She's given me heads so many times, you'd think I'd have noticed that. Next up is Not Lava Land. Gotta keep you on your toes. I head down into the pit to grab the poison DLC key. Oh yeah, I forgot. I need the key from the giants. Well, it's off to the Black Gulch then. I hate this game. Alright, one last drop. Game, I refuse to buy your cat ring, so how about I pay you in jank instead? The gutter has absolutely nothing interesting in it, so I'll just skip that, and even further down I get to Majula's toxic waste dump. Outplayed? I'm only here to beat up the giants, and after the first one dies, I could just quit out and the game will glitch and give me the key, but I felt like I should take down the second one properly. And by that, I mean from far away and with a crossbow. Before taking on the Rotten, I thought I would grab some fire paper just for some extra damage, but Sharon shows up. That's fine though, she's an easy... Before taking on Sharon, I thought I would grab the stone ring for some extra poise, so I take on this ogre. I really should have just gotten this ring first, it makes the alone knights much easier to deal with. Anyway, Sharon is now share off, and I buy a handful of fire paper. One last thing to do that is overall the smart play would be to upgrade my rapier to the max. So I take out this crystal lizard. I said I take out this crystal- seriously? I'll use my crossbow. I take out this crystal shithead, and combined with some of the other chunks I got, I make my rapier a +9. Why not +10, you ask? Because I'm poor. Luckily, I know a guy for that. Well, hello there, you trash bag with arms. How are you doing today? The Rotten does his thing, and by that I mean he swings a big axe around hoping to cut me to pieces, but you know what they say about playing with knives. You'll cut your hand off. I actually think this is the first time I've ever cut his hand off, so that's cool. Too bad I don't get the Moonrock Great Axe from it or anything. I go ahead and +10 my sword and +4 my crossbow just because, then go get the Dragon Talon and finally arrive in Shulva's Sanctum City. Something something bad hitboxes, I guess. Very slowly, I make my way through this DLC until I am just a couple rooms away from my prize. Unfortunately, the game can sense when I'm having fun and decided to kill me. Second time, instead of spending 30 minutes slowly making my way there, I just sprint through everything in hope. Surprisingly, it paid off and I get Flynn's Ring. I figured while I was in the area, I might as well progress, that way when I came back, I could just jump straight into the DLC bosses. Unfortunately, I skill issued all over the place. Yeah, I think I'm good for now. Back in Lethal Lava Land, I get invaded by Dennis, but he's no match for my newfound power. Okay, he was almost a match, but a win's a win. Something something pain in the ass run back, something something Smelter easy with ADP. You didn't see that. Smelter definitely gave me a bit of trouble in my soul level 1 playthrough, but here because I actually have iframes, he's kind of a joke. He hits hard and whatnot, but like, just don't get hit, am I right? Based on the damage shown, he literally survived with 1 HP, but there was no comeback for him. Well, unless you count Blue Smelter, but I don't really know if that's the same Smelter Demon or a different one. Someone please explain the lore in the comments for why there are two Smelter Demons. Anyway, I spawn Sir Stalks a lot and take him down a peg for the Ring of Blades +1. With that, the only thing left to do is to navigate the rest of Iron Keep because we all know the level is way harder than the actual boss. I'm so sad that old Iron King is as easy as he is. He looks so missing in the distance, but he's probably one of the easiest bosses in the whole game. I don't know why I keep buying Bright Bugs, I hardly ever use them. With the fire off, I safely pick up the Iron Key, which I then take back to the Forest of Fallen Giants to grab a heavier Iron Key, which I then use to open the DLC. I'm only here to grab the Dexterity Ring. Thankfully, it's right at the beginning, and now I can finally make my way to the Duke's Dear Freya. It totally isn't necessary to use a torch with this boss. I mean, it's honestly a pretty easy fight, but it goes from easy to, like, baby easy mode if you do. You know, I'm pretty sure I still have never knocked off one of her heads. I heard it's pretty easy to do if you use a piercing weapon, but it's just never happened for me. Though, now that I'm thinking about it, maybe I don't want head from her. With 3 out of the 4 primeval bosses down, I figured I might as well round out the cast, so it's back to the Lost Bastille. First, however, I must get through the Rune Sentinels. The game doesn't expect me to be here with a +10 weapon though, so it's less of a fight and more of a beatdown, each one of them taking about 6 hits to bring down. Sure would be cool to do it in one hit though, wonder if anyone has ever done something like that. It was at this point I decided I actually did want to collect more souls per kill, so I head back to Majula to commit fratricide for the Sildora set. Murdering a dear friend is a great segue to the next boss, the Lost Sinner. Normally this boss has some of those Dark Souls 2 hitboxes, but with as many iframes as I have, she's actually a joke. She only managed to hit me one time, and it's because I didn't even roll. Seriously, look at this. You can't tell me that at a lower ADP level, that wouldn't have registered as a hit. Oh well, I'll take the easy first try, and with that, I have...
Thanks, I wasn't using those organs anyway.
As I was saying before I was so rudely blown up, I can now access Dranglake Castle. I head inside, but really I'm only here for the Frozen Flower, which grants me access to the worst DLC, Ilium Lois. I hate this place. It is hands down my least favorite DLC. This place is actually the 9th level of hell. Au contraire, there are at least 2 things I want in this dead city. The first is behind this big stupid cat. Well, technically I could get the other thing first, but I figured I might as well take down Ava. Is what I thought I would do, but I ended up dying to her like 12 times and decided getting the Ring of the Embedded first was smart. Even then, it still took me a handful of tries. Don't get me wrong, this fight is way easier than at SL1, I just suck at this game. Sure, it would be awful if I had to fight 2 giant cats at once. Finally, after like 45 minutes of struggling, I can claim my prize, the Vessel Shield. To be honest, I don't know why I wanted this. I mean, yes, it does up several of my stats, but it's not going to be game-breaking. Oh well, an increase is an increase, I guess. Enough of the frozen wasteland, though. Back in the castle, I take down the twin dragon riders, and just to show dominance, I parry the opening attack, but I quickly learn that I shouldn't play with my food. Second try, though. I still didn't learn my lesson, but at least this time I got away with it. Two tries is probably the most I've ever taken for this fight, honestly. I can't put my finger on it, but something about this feels wrong. I can't put my finger on it, but something about this feels right. Looking Glass Knight, a boss that has potential to be a right pain in my ass. Mostly because of his summons. I've said it before and I'll complain about it again. I just absolutely suck at dealing with any kind of PvP fight. Not sure what it is, honestly. I just never got the hang of them. Lucky for me, though, once again, the Looking Glass Knight just didn't spawn anything. I don't know if he wants this run to be over as much as I do or what, but he kinda just zapped his sword and spun in circles a lot. Whatever, I'll take it because the next area is the dreaded Shrine of Awful. Okay, honestly, this place isn't that bad because I have a ranged option. Being able to aggro enemies from afar and lure them to their death is great. I can't imagine going through this area as pure melee though. I've always wondered, what happens if I attack Kermit while out of his range? Ah, he just goes into defense mode and the fight starts. Why didn't I expect that? He actually used an attack I'm not sure I've seen before, and it taught me to fear the frog. Second time though, I show him I have the superior range attack and take him out with a crossbow. Damn, good job on that realism, FromSoft. Really captured what it's like when I talk to the ladies. Oh hey, Aldia. No, really, it's fine. I like being flung around like a ragdoll. The crypt is an area I feel like I just speed through. I mean, I feel that way because I do, but I just wonder if I'm missing anything cool around here. Now, well, a mystery for another day, I suppose. Up next is everyone's favorite bellboy, Veldstab. He's an easy boss. As long as you remember, he has a wicked backswing. Second try, I make sure to be mindful, and he goes down without an issue. Well, hello there, King Vendrick. Looking a little hollow there. Can I offer you a humanity in this trying time? I have so much ADP, I can literally phase through his sword. I grab the King's Ring, then finally hit 99 adaptability, and as you can see, I can clearly drink Estus much faster. Right, so Aldia's Keep. I knew it was coming, and still got hit by it. No, that wasn't a bit, I'm actually that stupid. Hello, Mr. Guardian Dragon, I'm here for your ankle acupuncture appointment. Just let me relieve all that stress you have, and there we go. That'll be $500. Oh, hi, small Aldia. You can act cute and tiny all you want, but I'm still gonna kill you. Hey, look, I got the rare Emerald Herald animation. I mean, that's cool. So anyway, back to stabbing. I totally wanted to fight these guys legit just to feel like I won the duel, but I died like twice, and that's three times too many, so I ran by them and into the Ancient Dragon Arena, where I proceeded to do my best impersonation of Infectious Toe Jam. About a minute and a half later, I have an extra soul of a giant. Hey guys, it was a prank. Be cool, be cool! Next task up is to get more of those souls, so I dive into some memories. You know, if I had a nickel for every time I knew something was going to break out of a wall and probably kill me, I'd have two nickels. Which isn't a lot, but goddamn am I stupid. Okay, I'm not even mad at that one. That was just funny. So I hate to say it, but the Giant Lord killed me not once, but twice. Yes, I am as embarrassed as you think I am, but third time's a charm, and now I'm ready to commit high treason against Drangleic. The fight was going as you'd expect it would. Yep, exactly as you'd expect it would. Vendrick, buddy, tell the nice people we were just horsing around in that last encounter, right? Something to make the people laugh. Thanks, bud. I'm pretty close to the end, but there are still a handful more bosses, so I think it's time for the lightning round. First up is the Flexile Sentry, and I flex on him hard. Next is the Belfry Gargoyles, whose bells get rung. Royal Rat Authority, more like Royal Rat Servitude to my blade. Royal Rat Vanguard, more like Royal Rat... dead. Old Dragon Slayer gets slayed like the old dragon out front. And last, Ye Old NASCAR gets cheesed into the abyss. Cool, now every boss except for the DLC and the final gauntlet are finished. Yep, there is absolutely nothing else in the base game, nothing lurking in the dark at all. Ah, fine, I'll do the Dark Lurker. Stupid Covenant making me do stupid Dark Diver and stupid three stupid places and parry stupid Howl and stupid places and stupid... Dark Lurker. I like this boss. I know I just did a bit where I was complaining, but like, okay, the Pilgrims of the Dark is a cool covenant. I like what they did, but be honest, even the most diehard Dark Souls 2 fan who plays the game once a week aren't like...
Oh boy! Pilgrims of the Dark.
Right? Like, no one wants to do the run-up every time. Everyone wants to just fight the cool edgy Kingdom Hearts boss. Speaking of, he's easy. I don't think I've ever really struggled with this boss. At least not to the degree I see a lot of people talking about it. Maybe I'm just too overpowered with my, like, 11 strength and dexterity. Who knows? Right, now I am truly done with the base game. I hope. Dark Souls 2 has so many bosses, I wouldn't be surprised if I miss one, but I'm pretty sure it's fine, so it's time to move on to the DLC. I'm gonna start with the poison one just because I'm already basically done with it. Also, it's not the ice one, so there's that. Alana is pretty easy. She takes me 2 tries, but that's because I'm bad at video games. Her skeletons all go down in 2 shots, so that means it's pretty easy to take 2 of them out right as she summons them, then, as long as I'm careful, the 3rd one a few moments later. Then, it's just a matter of staying close to her and baiting easy melee swings. Next up is Sin, the Morning Breath Dragon. I'm going to be honest here. This fight was so easy with a decent amount of iframes, I almost felt like I was cheating. Near the end of the fight, I got him in some kind of fire breath loop I hadn't seen before. He just kept trying to hit me with fire and it kept not working for him. Also, I cut off his tail, so there's that. Last up is the Gang Squad, and I 100% cheesed the hell out of this fight. First, I did some drive-by shaking on Kara, Sierra, whatever. I did some drive-by shaking on Big Bow McShoots a lot, then hid behind these spikes and casually poisoned the other two. I wanted to do a no fear parry Havel for the victory, but he healed while I was getting into position, kind of ruining the moment. Oh well, he died shortly after. With that down, I head over to the Fire DLC. I'll be honest, at this point, I was just wanting the run to be over, not because I don't like the game, but because it's so damn long to run. So I started throwing myself off platforms to try to get to the bottom faster. It sort of worked. I mean, I did get to the bottom faster, just not in one piece. Eventually, I find my footing and grab the Strength Ring, the only important part on my way down to the Fume Knight. I'm definitely starting to feel the difference ADP makes. Like, I got pretty good at dodging his attacks during the SL1 run, but here I felt like I just went Ultra Instinct on him.
You didn't see that.
Totally first try Fume Knight, let's go! Oh boy, Iron Passage. I'm gonna keep it real with y'all. I ran through the area and save-stated outside the boss fog. I know, doom you so bad, just get good, just murder them 12 times to stop them from spawning. Yeah, I could do that. Anyway, Blue Smelter. A much, much more enjoyable fight when you have more iframes than a defective toaster, I tell you what. I mean, he still took me 6 tries, but that's fine because it was actually enjoyable fighting him and not wonky hitboxes. Last but definitely not least is Sir Alone. Honestly, probably my favorite boss in all 3 DLCs. I mean, Burnt Ivory King has a magnificent entrance, but once you've seen it, it kinda loses its luster. But Sir Alone? Ah, he's cool every time. And oh, look at that, a horribly timed dodge on his grab, and it still missed! Just beautiful, I tell ya. I didn't manage to get the no-hit on him, but it was a first try, so I'll take that. With that, it's time to stop putting off my fears and take on the icy hell of Ilium Lois. First, I grab all 3 knights, then make a quick pit stop in the gutter to grab the Great Club. Oh yeah, it's clobbering time. Okay, well, the pancake strat is apparently no match for the stab me in the face strat, but that's fine, I'm nothing if not stubborn. Eventually, I keep the knights down long enough for Big Bro to step in and ask me to politely stop picking on them. Unfortunately, this fight is kind of unremarkable. I mean, not the fight itself, it's pretty cool looking, but just nothing happened. I hit him, he hit me, one of us fell over. I did manage to win with my Knight Bro still alive, and I had hoped that this would have him doing a cool animation or something, but he kind of just pieces out. Understandable. Alright, last up is actually hell, and you better believe I am summoning the NPCs to be reindeer bait. Even with 99 ADP, I still hate this place. You okay out there, O'Hara? You fine. 3rd try, we make it to the boss. I thank them by telling them to take a hike and then take on the king's pets. These cheap copies are far less of a threat than the original and go down on the first try, but not before I had a heart attack of getting Dark Souls 2 hitboxed right at the end. Seriously, game, can you just not with this kind of hit detection? With every boss conquered, it is time to put an end to this run. First up are the Throne Watcher and Defender. The dynamic duo put up a rather mediocre fight, but in the end are no match for my advanced dodging skills, and then Nashadra shows up to try and steal the throne right out from under me. But we all know she's an easy boss, just bait the melee hits and stay out of range of her magic attacks, and I died to Nashadra. I don't think I've ever died to Nashadra. Well, first time for everything. Sure would be embarrassing if I also died to Aldia. I noticed the intro cutscene changed as she's already in the room, but she still says the same thing. I highlight that because I'm definitely one of like 4 people in the world to have ever died to her, so... Wait, no, it was for research. Yeah, totally. 2nd try, Bone Mommy goes down for me. Also, I win the fight. Hello, you pile of twigs. I can't wait to cut you down to size. Honestly, the bright bug was totally unnecessary. Okay, maybe it wasn't unnecessary, game. I'm sorry. You know, now that I think about it, the only way Aldia could actually kill me is if I carelessly walked into his attacks. I mean, that explosion, his fire aura, literally I have to do the job for him, but he doesn't pay me enough. Literally, like at all. So he falls and I have beaten Dark Souls 2 while only leveling ADP. Thank you everyone for watching, and an extra special thanks to my patrons. Stay beautiful, y'all. If you enjoyed this video, please consider giving a like and subscribing. It really helps the channel out. And if you want to see more Dark Souls 2, check out the time I attempted to one-shot my way through it. I won't lie, I lost a piece of my sanity on that one. But until next time, my friends, don't you dare go hollow.